Day four will be remembered as the hardest day on the trip. We paddled all day. We had many, many portages. We ended up at marker 70, an unofficial campsite.
Here we are in the Bloodvein River, day four. Paddling through these beautiful little arms.
Well, it's Wednesday. We went on the river for 3 days. Today was a particularly tough day. We did a lot of rapids today, a lot of portages, many more than we anticipated, many more than we wanted. We had some spillage, a dump. I'm not sure how many portages we did today, four or five. It's hard to know. They just seem to come one after the other. These portages have been traveled for centuries by the Ojibwe and the European fur traders. They were so worn and beaten down that there was no need for trail markers. Upon reflection, we're all humbled when thinking about the many travelers over hundreds of years that have traveled these same portages. Whether it's for commerce, hunting, migration, they've all walked these same portages and slept on these same rocks.
It's a beautiful day here on the Bloodvein. And we're doing a great, big, frickin' portage.
In most cases, the canoe of Quentin and Clobber went down first. This gave us an opportunity to video the other canoes and to lounge and relax.
Yes, sir. It doesn't get much better than this. I got a bit of a wet ass.
The water, I think, is quite high this year, based on the descriptions of the rapids. The class 2 seem like class 3s, and the class 1s seem like class 2s.
Lots of fun. How about backpacking?
We stopped for lunch in this beautiful canyon, all unaware of the dangers to follow.
Warning. What you were about to witness was done by professionals. Please don't try this without the appropriate training, expertise, and technical support. These charitable and brave paddlers will be demonstrating the double gunnel grab at great risk to life and limb. This is for your benefit. Please pay attention. You will notice when the gunnels are grabbed, the paddles leave the water. Control and stability is lost, balance is compromised, and eventually the boat goes out of control. Let's watch this again in slow motion. It must also be noted, only because of the paddler's extreme agility and proven expertise, they were able to keep the boat upright. I must repeat, these are professionals. Don't try this yourself. Brought to you by the Canadian Council on Safe Boating.
I slid down the hill and landed on my knee. And I'm looking for all sorts of sympathy and free drinks tonight.
Yeah.
Parker slipped, bruised his knee while we were lining a boat around some rapids. We would navigate each set of rapids in one of four ways. We could run them, we could portage them, we could line them, and lastly, we could do a group lift.
Okay, let's get tracking here, folks. We got a long way to go.
What a wonderful campsite we're in here today. We're on the top of a cliff. We didn't plan on staying here. We had other plans. We were hoping to keep going and continue on with the rapids we're at right now, but we probably were wise and decided to stop here because we were all quite tired. Circling overhead, there's all sorts of airplane activity. We hear helicopters, looks like search and rescue planes. They're either doing an exercise or someone's hurt. We don't know what's going on up there.
One for me?
Ah, good stuff.
Hey, lead dog.
Yes, sir.
How does a cook get motivated?
Captain Morgan.
What's on the menu tonight?
How the hell do I know? I'm only cooking.
We're all exhausted today. We're just lounging around trying to recover some, really try to recuperate and gather some energy for tomorrow. First thing in the morning, we're going to tackle the rapids, and I think we're going to do well. All in all, it's a very good day, and I think right now we're all going to retire. Maybe a spot of whiskey or some rum prior to sleeping, but all in all, a very good day.